Wow, can you believe it? We're actually producing the show.
I know, it's great. I'm very proud of you and our team. We started with 4 people. Now it's over 25 people working on this project. So it's growing rapidly.
I have goosebumps. I know it's been your dream for a very long time. And I'm so happy we are making it true. We are actually from the same village. That's
Lilia,
what I
Lilia is from the village and I'm from the city called Kyiv. And then she thinks she's from Kyiv, but To be honest,
come on.
She's from the outskirts.
He always says it's outskirts. Technically, it's Kyiv. We're both from Kyiv, Ukraine, yeah. And it's the capital.
We are bilingual from the birth. And I think having, like, knowing more languages gives us and people who know many languages a great opportunity to communicate with a larger group of people and explore different cultures. I think what makes Ukrainians Ukrainians is just the same values. You can speak any language, you can live in different parts of the country, different parts of the world sometimes, like we are immigrants to the United States, but we still share the same values.
I think we value freedom a lot. We don't like to be told what to do.
Yeah.
Especially me. And I feel Ukrainians are very creative overall. We can find our way around, really, and we know how to fight for things.
Yeah, and navigate through difficult times.
Is it true that all Ukrainians start to dance at a very young age?
It is true for Ukraine, and me personally, I started to dance at 6.
I started when I was 4 years old, very early, yeah. I should say one of the best assets we have on the show is our dancers, right?
A lot of them are our friends. Some of them used to be our competitors when we were still
dancing.
We have discovered different personalities of our dancers during rehearsals.
The approach and how they practice and how they approach the show and the choreography itself. Somebody would go really deep into the details. Somebody would think a little bit broader.
Each individual couple that we have just by themselves is a powerhouse, and the stage for the show is quite big, but I am a little bit afraid that they have so much energy that they need a bigger stage at some point.
Well, yeah. We have to work on that now.
Lilia, what is your favorite music piece in our show?
I really love the rumba that we have, and it's in Ukrainian it's called U Vishnevomu Sadu. It basically means in a garden, in a cherry tree garden. And I'm so proud of how our composer arranged it and the story behind it. It's very pretty.
I agree. It's a very pretty song. Of course, our theme is Ukrainian folk theme, or we say between us, neo-folk.
We work with so many creative people from all over the world. They are on our team.
Our visual artist is one of the best, and he works with us from Ukraine during these difficult times. We're very, very grateful to him and to his team in Ukraine. And of course, the screens that we're using and different visual effects.
And the lights.
It definitely enhances the whole performance, especially for the dancers.
I'm very excited for this.
I am jealous for those dancers because when we used to compete, there was close to zero enhancement of our performance in terms of visual arts. But in here, this will be great.
I feel like the show has a great significance right now.
This is an unparalleled moment in history, and we are telling our own personal story as well as a story of many Ukrainians.
Join us on this journey of a human soul in pursuit of freedom and happiness in a cycle of modern Ukrainian history.
We are announcing North American tour for Kolo Dance Show.
Join us for the immersive experience celebrating Ukrainian culture through ballroom dancing, visual arts, and original music.